Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 7, practice test 4, section 3, no calculator. So, while preparing to run a marathon, Amelia created a training schedule in which the distance of her longest run every week increased by a constant amount. If Amelia's training schedule requires that her longest run in week 4 is a distance of 8 miles and her longest run in week 16 is a distance of 26 miles, which of the following best describes how the distance Amelia runs changes between week 4 and week 16 of her training schedule? Right? So essentially, if you look at the answer choices here, it talks about the increase, right? It just gives you different rates for the increase of the distance that Amelia travels, covers during her longest run. Okay? So, and what do I mean? The rates, right? The rate means the slope, right? The slope means the rate, right? The change in one variable with respect to change in another. Right? So let's see. So based on what we see here, the miles is going to be the change that will be in the numerator of the fraction, right? Because essentially, let's think of a slope as a fraction, right? Let's think of a fraction when we think of a slope, right? So change in one variable divided by the change in another. So we're thinking of a variable, of a fraction, right? So let's think of the numerator of this fraction must be the miles, and then the denominator must be the weeks, right? Because it says by 0.5 miles each week. But we don't know yet what the number is. We need to figure that out. So once you know for sure, once you label the numerator with the correct unit, you should be good to go. You will not make a mistake. Okay? So I'll show you what I mean by incorrect versus correct. So let's see. So you have two pairs, right? When you think of a slope, to calculate slope, you have to deal with two pairs. One pair of points, right? You have to deal with one pair of points. Each point will have an x and a y coordinate, right? So let's see. The y coordinate, you're going to use the y coordinates to find the change in y, right? The change in the number of miles. Right, and then you're going to use the x coordinate as the horizontal change, right? The denominator change, and that's going to be the change in weeks. Okay, so once you know that, you will see that you can use this information, right? So you're going to have what points are you going to have? You're going to have for the x. Let's take the first point. The first point could be. Let's see, so 5 miles each week, right? So we said that the mileage will be the y change, right? And then the weeks will be the horizontal change, right? So the miles must be the y, right? So once we know the y, we know that the first coordinate will be 4, 8, right? Because weeks, as we said, was the horizontal change, so weeks must pertain to the x-axis, which is the horizontal axis, right? So we're going to have 4, 8 as the first point. And then the second point, in order to determine the correct slope, will be 16, 26, right? Because the week 16 is the x-coordinate, and 26 miles is going to be the y-coordinate of the point, right? So it's going to be 16, 26. So now we have two points, and we can use these two points to calculate the slope, and then use that slope in order to understand what the right answer is here, right? So let's see. So based on that, using these two points, we find the change in y, right? The change in miles, which is going to be 26 minus 8, right? Change in the y, right? Divided by 16 minus 4, right? Because of the change in x, right? So once you do that correctly, you will have 18 over 12, and using the greatest common factor, which is 12, you can reduce it to 3 over 2. Oh, I'm sorry, not 12. 6 is the greatest common factor of 18 and 12, right? So divide both the numerator and denominator by 6, and you're going to have 3 over 2, right? And 3 over 2 is 1.5. So that means your slope is 1.5. So that means each week, and remember, 1.5 is still divisible by 1, right? So that means 1.5 miles are covered every week. You see, you just found the slope of the straight of the line, right? The straight line between these two points, 4,8 and 16,26. Okay, so you found that she covers 1.5 miles each week. So let's find this. And since this is positive, let's see where it says 1.5 miles each week. Bingo, right here. Amelia increases the distance of her longest run by 1.5 miles each week. Now, let's see what I was talking about when I said that if you label your units incorrectly, if you mess up the numerator and the denominator. So what do I mean by that? What I meant was if you put the 16 minus 4 on the top and then 26 minus 8 on the bottom, right? So for example, if you thought miles as being the y-axis label and then the weeks, I'm sorry, the miles if you thought of the x-axis and the weeks would be the y-axis, you would have gotten this completely incorrectly, completely incorrect, because you would have switched your numerator and denominator. As a result, you would have 26 minus 8 on the bottom and then 16 minus 4 in the numerator, and that would give you 2 over 3 instead of 3 over 2, and 2 over 3 would be this answer here, right? It would say Amelia increases the distance of her longest run by 2 miles every 3 weeks. You see? So the SAT, the College Board, knew that you could mess this up, and you would have chosen answer choice C, and that would be completely wrong, right? So this is what I mean by being careful to put the right units in the right place on your fraction, either the numerator or the denominator, right? So you have to label each numerator correctly with the correct unit and the denominator with the correct unit as well, right? So in this case, we did it correctly, so we wound up with a correct answer, answer choice D.